Hello everyone and welcome to my channel, my Channy Chan channel. We're continuing on with the Empire unboxing. As you see, this is the Bespin Security Guard, and there's Bespin Leia. And Lobot. Digest a review on. Apparently this is exclusive. There's two there. I was going to grab two, and I'm like, you know what? I don't need two. Yeah, this is really well. They only made two security guards: the white, this guy, and the black one. I think just like in 1980. I do have the 1980 version of the black Bespin security guard. All right. So, when I set up the carbon freezing chamber on a shelf, I'll probably put him in. The other one, I'll probably put Lobot by a house. So, there's the packaging. Yeah. I am opening it. I don't care. This is actually a thicker cardstock. Right? It's funny. That's thicker. You can hear that really good compared to Lobot. Actually, that's a thicker cardstock. No, that's thin. See how thin that is? And thin this is. Really, actually, this is thinner. This is like paper thin. Like, almost. This is thinner. This is a little thicker than that. And this is really thick. I don't know why they're not just sticking with, you know, the same. And you can tell this is a bit thicker. And there you go. There's the barcode if you want to scan it. If you can. Made in China, and you saw I showed the picture. I do have this R2. He's in a special case. So this is Helder Spinoza. Sorry if I'm butchering his name. To me, he's just a Bespin security guard. There's no names. They just gave him a name. All right. So there's the package. The set of package. Top, bottom. Yada yada. Meanwhile, there was more than two. Right, and there's one with a mustache and all that. Anyway, so without further ado, oh my gosh, he's opening it. I don't care. Some I care about, some I don't. I'm like, oh my god, you know what? It's gonna go on display. Can you display this on the carbon freezer chamber like that? No. Let's get her open. If we can. There we go. So there, a little cut there on there, but that's it. It's open. I gotta pry it in. There we go. Done. Voila. So there we go. Let's get them out. Really? Look at that. That's like an episode one blaster. I have no idea why they, like, okay, they're expensive, but cheap plastic. Now, we're just going to leave this here for a second. I want to point out something, if you can see that from there. Hopefully you can. This, way, like, seriously, like, come on, people. That's the only thing I don't like is the hat. It's, like, thick lines of paint. There is no paint. They're rivets. It's the style of the hat. So whoever designed this, Like, hello, McFly. Look, these are rivets. They're layers of the hat. Why couldn't they do that? Layers of the hat. Anyhow, basically it's gonna have different articulation from Lobot. It looks like, okay, it looks like the gauntlets, these are separate pieces. If you look closely, I know it's upside down. Oh well. Anyways, all right, let's look. See? The cuffs were put on after. Both cuffs. All right, they were put on after their separate mold. I don't understand why. That just doesn't look good. All right, well, you're not gonna, and the hands are just not, this is not a good start. Right now, it's a 9.5. It's a 9.5. Yeah, they didn't really do a good job. That is hard plastic. That's soft. Like, come on. Soft. This should be soft. That should be hard. Not really a big head movement there. Lobot's way better. The detail. All right, the detail, the paint. The paint's really good. I like the paint. The paint's nice. There's, like, no paint bleed. The boots are nice and shiny. The only thing is these. The separate piece, that's a hard plastic. It's like they put glued it on. They put this on. Yeah. But anyhow, let's see what the pistol. Let's see how that looks in his hand. Nice. So, get his hand and his arm turned. There we go. Alright, not bad. So we'll put that in the holster for now. Really soft, crappy plastic. So there, let's do the articulation. Nice rotation there on the head. Rotation on the arm, that's good. Up that far. The elbow, it's really good, actually, which is his nose. You can scratch his nose. And they're all rotation, pretty much, I guess they're all rotation in the elbows now, which is pretty good. And they're all pinless. Well, they were, weren't they? And the hand goes up and down like that, and a swivel. The rotation is up here in the chest area. No waist because of that. He can do the splits. Whoa, boy, oh boy, he can really do the splits. Holy crap. I think there is nothing getting in the way there. That's a Van Damme, way Van Damme. Damn. Splits, man. Holy crap. I know karate and jiu-jitsu and everything. I can kick your balls. Look. That far. Look at that. Quick kick, eat your heart out, man. Holy shit. Holy moly. Hey. Yes, this is a movie. That's a cartoon. But same company that makes the toys. There's the connection. But yeah. Alright. And rotation and knee bend. Knees go up that far. Oh, yeah. Legs go up that far. Nah, back that far. Rotation and pivot and the ankle. So, yeah. Get this figure if you want to complete your empire line. Or continue your empire line. So, there you go. That was the unboxing review of Bespin Security Guard, Helder Spinoza. Anyways, the Bespin Security Guard from Empire Strikes Back. Yeah, I recommend getting it. You know, but if you have a choice, if you're at the store and you see all three, either grab all three. But my opinion is that I would grab these two first. I guess if this is exclusive, so you have no choice. So grab all three. But if If they have a lot of him and less of these two, I've got these two first. Highly recommend it. But yeah, yeah. So there you go. Don't forget to like, comment, subscribe on the description below. And be well, and this is the way.